Hello, I'm Jason, and I'm an in-center hemodialysis patient.
Hi, I'm Nate, and I'm a dialysis nurse. We're here to talk about research that involves patients.
I've been on dialysis for 3 years now, and I've been asked to participate in research studies for a few times. At first, I wasn't sure what to think because I didn't know much about research, but I've learned more.
Jason and I helped make this video to teach people about dialysis research and what it means to participate. We hope that you find this 8-minute video helpful.
Let's start with what the word research means. Research is a process used to find out new knowledge or new information. It starts with an idea or a question. Research can be scientific experiments in a lab or studies with patients in a clinic. Research allows us to find new treatments and help patients. For example, the dialysis machines and medications we use today were created and tested through research, research that involved people like you. Most often, the goal of research is to make discoveries that will help future patients. Research can be exciting and can lead to promising treatments. But like many things, it may come with challenges. Research can take a long time and doesn't always give clear answers. If you decide to participate in research, you may not see its effect on your own medical care, but it could help others in the future. Many people think about medicines when they hear the word research. As a dialysis patient, you may take binder pills or blood pressure medicines. As a clinic staff, you may give patients EPO or iron. Years of research went into making these medicines, and thousands of patients, clinic staff, and doctors made them possible by participating in the research studies that tested them. It was a team effort. Now let's take a moment to talk about types of research. There are a lot of different types of research. There are studies that test new medicines to treat symptoms like itching and upset stomach. Others about ways to stop cramping and blood pressure drops, and still others about how to increase the number of kidney transplants. So far, we've talked about research that asks volunteers to do something like take a medicine or complete a task. You may hear this called a clinical trial. A clinical trial is a type of study that tests health-related treatments or procedures. But research is more than clinical trials. Research can include reviewing information from medical charts or asking people what they think or how they feel about a topic. Research comes in all shapes and sizes. Studies can be small, with a few patients at just one clinic, or they can be big, with thousands of patients from many countries. Studies can be short, such as doing just one interview, or they can be long, where patients are followed over many years. Every study is a little different. In general, research is how scientists and doctors answer questions and get information that they hope can be used to improve the lives of future patients.
Wow, I didn't realize that there were so many types of research. I was in a study a while back where I talked about symptoms that bother me on dialysis. I was with a group of patients that got together and the research asked us questions. I enjoyed hearing others talk about their symptoms, and it felt pretty good to know that sharing my story could help.
I once helped in research by giving patients a study medication. I chose to help because I wanted to support patients beyond those in my own clinic. Jason, what made you want to participate?
Well, Nate, I wanted to help others who sit in a chair like me. I wanted to try to give them a better future so maybe they wouldn't have to go through what I've gone through. I volunteered because the researchers took the time to explain the study to me, and that made me feel comfortable.
Let's go back to the video and learn more.
If you are interested in participating in research, there are important things to know. No matter the type, no matter the size, no matter the length, all studies are reviewed by experts, not involved with the research itself. This group of experts is called an Institutional Review Board, or IRB for short. The IRB makes sure that studies are safe and that people have a way to get out of the study if they want to stop. All researchers work from a written plan that they have to follow. The IRB must review and approve this plan before a study can start. If you are asked to participate in research, you should never feel pressure to do it. It's your choice. And if you do decide to participate, you can change your mind and stop at any time. Stopping or leaving a study will not affect your dialysis care. It's important to know that research can have risks, and depending on the study, participants may experience discomfort or harm. Any and all risks must be explained to people before they sign up to participate. Researchers and the IRB make sure that any risks are as small as possible and that patients know who to go to if they have problems or questions. For most studies, you will be asked to sign a consent form. A consent form has information about the study's possible risks and benefits. It also tells you why the research is being done and how it might help others. This way, you know what you're signing up for. All researchers must also make sure that your information is kept safe and confidential. Only researchers can access your study information, no one else. Altogether, this means that researchers must follow many rules to make sure you are safe and protected. Research has many steps that you may never see. Although research may have risks, and those risks differ depending on the study, there are many reasons why you might want to participate. For example, you might want the chance to learn from others' experiences or help future dialysis patients. Or you might be interested in the research topic or just want to learn about new things. It is important to remember that some research does not lead to clear answers, and many times research does not lead to a direct benefit for those participating in the study. However, studies that don't lead to clear answers can lead to new ideas. And new ideas can lead to more research and eventual benefits for future patients. But even small studies may take a while. Research takes a lot of time. Researchers should tell you how long a study will take and when you should expect updates. But if they don't, be sure to ask. It's important that you ask researchers all your questions. All questions are good questions. The goal of research is to create better futures for people on dialysis, those who care for them in clinics, and those who help them at home. Your involvement in research as a patient, care partner, staff member, or doctor is important. You are an important member of the team. Research is going on around us all the time. Today's research could help the patients of tomorrow have a better future.
Thank you for watching our video.
Hey, even making this video involved research. Thank you to the more than 75 dialysis patients, care partners, clinic staff, and doctors who gave us the ideas that shaped this video. It was a team effort. To learn more about research and find kidney research opportunities for you, go to
I had it.
You got this.
Yeah, I had it.
I'm messing up now too.
All right,
let's take.
Yeah. Let's just take a breath. Kenny, when you're ready.
Goose from
involved.
Okay, that's fine. So we're still rolling, and we're going to do
dissolved.
Uh-oh.
Okay. Still rolling.